As the project manager for a new product launch at an electronic company, you are faced with a critical decision regarding the procurement of a specialized component. The component is essential for your product, and the two options are under consideration. Both options are known to meet the project's high quality standards. Yeah. So the primary concern in managing the project within its budget constraint, your primary concern is that the following information has been provided. So what I'm sensing from here is I need to do make or buy decision. Yeah. And I have to focus that more on budget space because both the options are giving sufficient quality output. Let's see. Manufacturing the component in-house, initial setup cost $40,000, additional variable cost $60,000. So overall total in-house manufacturing cost is $100,000. So the question has done the total. Sometime I need to calculate that particular total. So I can say in-house work is $100,000. The purchasing the component from an external supplier, the quoted price for the required quantity is $120,000. Okay, so $20,000 extra. No additional costs are involved, just this $120,000. $120,000 is something needed. Which option would you suggest and why? Okay, so it has a why also. So from a basic calculation, I can see that I should go with the in-house development because it's $20,000 cheaper. Probably we need to select, if we have more than one option talking about option in-house, then probably need to select which one is more appropriate from the why part of the question. So let's see the option. Option A, manufacture the component in-house as it present a lower cost compared to the purchasing from the external supplier. Looks good. Yeah, so I say that I should do it and the why part is also clear to me. So this option looks great for me as of now. Option B, purchase the component from external suppliers, assuming the higher cost is justified by avoiding the complexity of in-house production. Now, if I do that, I'm thinking too much. Because in general, when I'm focusing on make or buy decision, I don't have to extrapolate information based on my own perceptions. I should stick to the facts and data given in the question. So I clearly see the facts are showing this option is 20,000 more. And I clearly see the question is also indicating that your focus is managing the project within budget. So I can definitely ignore taking it from outside. Option C, manufacture the component in-house, yes. Focusing on the long-term benefit of developing production capabilities. Now here it becomes close. So A and C both are talking about the same thing, but what is the reason? Now in the question, the reason related to long-term benefits, production capability are not discussed. So if I'm choosing option C, I am adding information to it. Whereas option A is very clear-cut saying that it is cheap, do it. Yeah, that is what which is clearly available in the question. So I stick to option A over option C, and option C is basically added for confusing me while I'm selecting the choices. Option D, purchase the component from the external supplier, focusing on the simplicity of procurement and awareness of initial setup cost. So I know initial setup cost is there, but anyway, it is overall cheap. So it is, again, I don't want to go for an expensive option You may think, oh, it might be problematic to set up initial things. It is not coming in the question. We are saying it just cost us 20,000 less. Why don't we go for 20,000 less option? Because as a project manager, I need to focus on maximizing the return for my organization. I need to utilize the resources at an optimal level, and money is an important resource. So we should be going with option A and focusing on in-house way of working. So you can expect this kind of question where you need to do a small make or buy analysis. So this particular question is mapped to task 11, plan and manage procurement in your exam content outline. And the topic is definitely make or buy decision.